3 months ago, a video was released where an American and a Canadian put their minds together to solve the mystery of this single Gmod ARG that they found while binging YouTube. They worked endlessly to mend the pieces together in a way that made sense, and when the project was complete, they moved on to separate projects, coming together once again temporarily to fend off the vicious horde of wild Uncle Danes. But now that enough time has passed, and enough content has been created, the dynamic duo has returned.
Back. Sorry for the long wait, everyone, but you know how it is. Alright, you clicked on this video, you know why you're here, let's not waste any time. And if you just found this video randomly on your recommended and are a first-time viewer, go watch the last video, because that'll give you all the information you need. Or don't, I don't know. Anyway, now that you're hopefully caught up, allow the three of us to- Wait a minute. Oh, three! That's right, baby! Regular Citizen wasn't the only one to add another member to their roster, so ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the newest member of the research team, the American Tommy. This guy. Him. Alright, with that out of the way, let's get on to the interesting things. So we got an interview with Regular Citizen. Yeah, I don't know how either. The night the video went live, we were in the Regular Citizen Discord server, which is... It's a very normal Discord server that you should check out, where the man himself started talking to us about some fun little factoids and misconceptions within the video. So we're gonna go through those. Also, yes, we have permission to use these screenshots. First and foremost, answering the biggest question from the last video, the identities of the blue engineer, blue sniper, and red medic from functioning server. And the answer is... Yeah. It also means that... The doctor has time-stopping abilities. Fuck!
Moving on from that, we'd like to share one really quick misconception from the last video, which was brought to our attention by an inside informant. Thank you, Damon. Specifically, the fact that the environments in Border World and Exit that Regular Citizen winds up in are two completely different places. Looking back on it now, the fact that Tim didn't pick up on that is kind of embarrassing.
I'm right here!
But that should be it for the behind-the-scenes content. Now we're getting into what you people care about, so without further ado, let's get started.
To start things off, let's look back at the friend group channels themselves. And so far, only two major things have occurred, one of them being that both Snowman and the EXP have changed their banners to killstreak counters with a count of 1 and 8, respectively. What this means is unclear, but with it being a killstreak counter, some obvious but unproven theories come to mind.
The second and most important thing to bring up is that a new member has joined the roster in the form of Mediman, the Red Medic. And judging by his at, he might have been the first medic in the group before the doctor joined. His channel is easy to access as it has been added to the channel section of Regular Citizen's page. In addition, Mediman's shoutouts, as he calls them, consist of Taquito, Finders Keepers, Gordon Pro, Proplazers, Regular Citizen, and Snowyman. At this time of recording, there are currently no videos on his channel to speak of. Alright, now that we're all caught up in terms of the state of the channels, let's get to the videos. Hit it!
Right off the bat, we have an 8-second video with zero audio. It goes pretty quickly, so try to keep up. It shows us who the group used to be composed of before the doctor intruded on them. This intro is interesting because of the fact that it gives the unnamed red medic from the CTF sawmill video a name. Mediman. Despite this, the Mediman channel wouldn't be created until almost exactly a month after the video was uploaded. It also excludes Gmod Pro, Finders Keepers, Gordon Gmod, Pro Blazers, and... Well, I would say the Doctor isn't included, but he is at the end of the video for a frame. Something else to note is that when Taquito is shown, the bloodstain on his helmet is there. Probably not important, but... you know.
Police Report 05 consists mostly of a black screen with two images appearing. The first one is blink and you'll miss it, and the second one sticks around for only a little bit longer.
Alright.
Yes.
Uh- image consists of a bright red floor with some text underneath that is too low quality to read with the naked eye. After some expert editing and eyeballing, we believe spells out this sentence. We have reason to believe that the writer of this might be the doctor. Why? More on that later. Onto the second image, which looks like...
So there was a flash at the beginning.
Yeah, there's this
thing.
Now how to
go frame by frame.
I have a better idea.
No, don't slow down. There's actually a way to go frame.
This. There's a lot to suggest here, so bear with me. This is a missing persons report for a certain Matt V. Morley, which they think was found roughly in the same woods that we saw in the exit video. It states that he was found being both injured and confused, and on the left of the page is a list of suspects. The suspects being a Lionel Mitch, who is circled in red, a Dmitry Morozov, who is crossed out, Oliver Pixwell, who has nothing done to his name, and lastly David Green, who is also crossed out. All of them are labeled as Matt V's friends. And under the suspect's name, Lionel is listed again, being pinned as the main suspect in Matt V's disappearance, along with his previous offenses, which are too low quality to see what they are. This will draw focus on what's been drawn in the case file itself. First and foremost, Ace has been crossed out and replaced with the word hell. Sounds like Sam put their hands on this one before it went public. Anyway, the drawings consist of a human eye on the left, the Team Fortress emblem on the right, text next to the X'd out image of the forest saying, don't go there, a drawing of a stickman standing over another stickman laying in a pool of red, wonder what that means, an M written over top those two stickmen, a list of double O's going from 1 to 10, which ends in the source logo, and also a drawing of the gateway. And finally, this. We spent a good chunk of time trying to decipher this. Sourcing different languages, reverse Google image searching. Hell, I even tried to learn heretic Norwegian and came up empty-handed. So fuck it. We're outsourcing it to you people. Let us know what you came up with in the comments below. I'm sure Sam will be happy to read them.
Wait, what?
Don't worry about it.
Alright, kicking off the next video, we have... What the fuck? Oh, hey guys, we got a fed in here! We start off with four pictures taken during the Matt V. Morley investigation, which claimed the corkboard images were found in the victim's house and the notebook was found at the scene of the first murder? I assume this means the police thought that Matt V. Morley was dead? Which makes a lot of sense now that I think about it, because when Matt V's missing person alert went out and broadcast, the police assumed he was dead. So, okay, this actually kind of makes sense. Unless I'm entirely wrong, but we're not going there. The next image reveals a journal entry, pause to read, written by Oliver Pixwell, who is revealed to be none other than Snowyman 008. Well, this is interesting. Moving on to the next page, we get three more name drops. Doc, who is the doctor, Alex, who is Mediman, and Dimitri, who we're pretty sure is the EXP. Afterwards, we get this image, which is similar to the Crimson 4 in the last video. Are these connected? Probably, I don't know.
So next, we have another tutorial which removes Gmod viruses from 2011. Finally, we have something going on in the description, where Mediman is credited for finding a way to remove said virus. Just go through the game files, find this thing, obliterate the doctor's plan, and your game should be fixed! Yay! So, Wanted starts with a looping gif of a spinning bone saw, which then cuts to an emergency alert that will eliminate what remains of your hearing.
Hang on. I don't think my audio is being correct. Give me a second.
Oh my god!
Oh, that's what's going on. I couldn't hear a damn thing, so...
Can you start it over?
Regular Sinister should just make a gif of this.
Oh, please.
The alert in question is for a wanted 15-year-old. Apparently, Oliver Pixwell is considered dangerous and wanted by the British police due to an anonymous caller. What for? I don't know.
Gordon Dima 004 starts off over a full decade in the past. In the year 2010. We're back in Egypt, just like old times. We see the doctor and the EXP observing the gateway, which at one point the camera pans over to... Holy sh... The camera pans over to an extremely dead probe lasers. Then it cuts to black. Then we fade into Barn Blitz. It then cuts to... Oh, god damn.
As soon as I saw the name of the video...
No!
We see Mediman standing over Gordon Giamat. then the video ends.
Misplacement is my personal favorite, mainly because of how this thumbnail turned out. Poor baby. The video stars the Doctor, in a black room, looking around. A Half-Life 2 zombie then appears and either the Doctor teleports or the zombie gets fucking eviscerated as he looks over to it. Either way, the screen zooms out, and text appears, showing that the Doctor has successfully entered the Half-Life 2 engine. The text remains for a split second, at which point Jimmy smiles, wanders off to... I don't know, join the combine. The video tells us that the Doctor, likely using the gateway, is able to travel to different source games. So if you're playing, I don't know, Left 4 Dead 2 or something, God help ya. What the fuck?
Mediman's Plan Part 1 starts off with the recovered 00 friend group intro, with music, might I add, and then cuts to a simple SFM featuring Mediman and Regular Citizen, with them doing a whole lot of moving around and being stiff as boards. And Mediman makes this face. He's so cute. About 30 seconds into the video, it then cuts to black.
Oh!
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 Mediman! This, we're pretty sure, is the aftermath of the events of the experiment. Hey, wait a second. It's also important to note that after this video is uploaded, Snowy Man's profile picture changed from blue to white, with him striking a new pose, and EXP's profile picture changing from yellow to red, signifying his death. LOL!
About 2 days later, a second video is uploaded, which kicks off with this sequence. Yet another gateway, with these two standing in front of it. Then it cuts to black for a few seconds, then cuts back to a performance by Snowy Man, Finders Keepers, and Taquito. Look at them go. Talented. They don't even need drumsticks. Then it cuts to black again, you know the drill by now, and then it shows us... Oh. Oh, we're back here.
We're back with the boys!
Are they, like, buddies?
Oh, what do we do? They're talking! In TF2, I'd say he's gone to HL2. Why Half-Life?
Oh.
Scout, where is this going? No! No! Fuck off! I did not-
Hey, wait a minute.
I was joking! I was joking when I said that!
You have been promoted.
This. Single goddamn clip is so fucking loaded it's about to burst. So I'll just leave that rant for another day. Likely. Maybe. Probably not. Whatever. Moving on.
If you were to look on Regular Citizen's YouTube channel, you would see that the videos we've covered so far is all that's been released. However, that's not the case, as there are two videos on the channel that are either unlisted or outright privated. More on that later. There is one unlisted video that we are capable of accessing. And to do that, you need to go to this website, which is linked to Regular Citizen's YouTube channel, scroll to the bottom of the website, and click this. And that's how we get to this video. A training tape for the Reality Containment Enforcers, or RCE for short. After some walls of text, pause to read if you want.
I have a question.
What's your question, soldier?
Jumping into the gateway can cause limb distortion. Is that why the XP was so long?
That's a good point.
He's just, like, really long.
So, EXP wasn't long because of some horrific experiment gone wrong, or because it's just in his genes. He's like that because he's a fucking idiot. We then get to see the blue scout peeking out from a corner. How lovely! It's later now, which means we get to look at the other private video. It was previously uploaded 5 days after misplacement, but for unknown reasons was privated shortly after. Thankfully, I was able to record the video and reactions before that happened. So instead of treating it as a legitimate entry into the Regular Citizen saga, we opted to mash it together with a bunch of non-canon behind the scenes and scrapped content. For example,
and finally, kicking off, we're in a new map, Doomsday. where up top we have what looks like the Blue Scout next to a big old machine with numbers. Down below we have what looks like another gateway, with our good friends Gordon Gmod and Mediman watching from the sidelines. We get a nice close-up of the two and... ugh. Gordon does not look healthy. After that close-up, we see the two look into the exit, then the camera zooms directly into it. The screen cuts to black and holy crap, it's the XP in real life, standing in a red room and staring at his gaming setup. And then the video ends. We likely would have spent the rest of this segment's time debating what this means for the timeline, but this video is now private, which likely means that it has no connection to the main story anymore.
And now you can breathe. We're completely caught up on the regular citizen lore once again. And just like before, once more ARG-related content releases, you can bet whatever you have left after betting your life savings that a sequel will come shortly after. Once again, thanks for watching. Change the world.
Ah, so this is where you've been.
The hell do you want?
This came in just this morning, a few kilometers away from Tokyo.
What?
Get your team together and group up at the station.
You got it, big guy.
What was that all about? Who was that?
That was the general.
Well, yeah, but what's he doing here?
Telling you and I to suit up. Call Green, we're being redeployed.
What?
I should have expected this.
What's that supposed to mean? Guys?
I think the Akimbo is the second best.
Yeah. Alright, let's go.
Look! Not including the melee weapons.
Wait! No, be quiet.